Good morning, friends, and welcome to our worship e-service today. As we gather on this very special Sunday of Palm Sunday, welcome. I want to encourage you, if you've got your palm branch or your palm cross with you, to keep it with you as we come and we worship God in this time of worship together today. Welcome. Friends, as we come in the space of worship, I want to encourage you to worship as you feel comfortable. If you want to sing the words out, you're more than welcome to do so. If you want to sit quietly and reflectively, you're more than welcome to do so as well. All I ask is that we worship God as we come together in this moment and in this worship e-service together as brothers and sisters in Christ. To get us going this morning, we're going to sing together, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. Friends, let us come and worship God together in this space. Friends, as we continue to worship God in this moment, I want to read a call to worship from Psalm 118, verses 1 and 2. And it reads as follows from the New International Version of the Holy Bible. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let Israel say, his love endures forever. Friends, we can say together in this moment, his love endures forever, forever. Welcome again as we gather as brothers and sisters in Christ, as we gather in this our worship e-service this morning. And we're joined with our brothers and sisters in Christ who are joining us through in-person worship services at our church sites, who will be joining us through our live stream service as well a bit later on today. But friends, as we gather in this moment, welcome. If you're not quite sure who I am, my name is Raymond. I'm a Methodist minister serving in the Mekgale Circuit of the Methodist Church of Southern Africa. And I want to welcome you into our service today. And if you're new, you're welcome to participate as you feel comfortable. Welcome. So friends, as we gather as a community of faith, and as has become our custom in our services, both in person and in our e-services as well, we light a candle as a reminder of the light of Christ with us, that the love of God endures forever. That in this moment as we gather, Christ is with us. That God is here in this moment as we gather as the children of God for worship in this space. God knows us, the light of Christ shining into the darkness of our world. With that in mind, we come to a word of prayer. Let us pray. Father, you are the God who loves us, and your love endures forever. So we give you thanks, Almighty God, that you are with us in this moment, and that your love is with us, walking in every moment and every situation with us in which we find ourselves at this time. We give you thanks that you have never left us nor forsaken us, and that as we have journeyed just over a year of national lockdown in our country, that you have been with us in every moment and every situation. So we come and we ask, Father, be with us now. Open our eyes and our hearts to your presence. Father, as we come in this moment as well, we come and we lay before you our confession of sin. For we know we're not perfect. We fall short. We mess up. We break community with you and with others. So friends, in this moment of quiet, I want to invite you to lift up your prayers of confession of sin to God. Lift up your prayers now. So, Father, as we lift up these, our prayers, we say we're sorry for the things we have done. And we hear and receive afresh the words of grace. Your sins are forgiven. Go and sin no more. So, Almighty God, we thank you that you are the one who brings forgiveness. That you are with us, Almighty God. And we give you thanks, Lord, that your goodness and love endure forever. That you are with us in every moment and situation. But we also ask that you would strengthen us to turn away from sin and back to you, that we would repent of the sin in our lives, particularly that which has become so habitual and entrenched in our lives. Strengthen us to turn away and back to you. Father, guide us now as we continue to worship. Strengthen us as we continue to seek you in community with each other as well. For we ask this in Jesus' holy and precious name. Friends, the peace of the Lord be with you. And I hear you saying, and also with you, Raymond. So friends, as we gather as the forgiven children of God in this moment of worship, we pass that peace to each other. We continue to seek to be peacemakers into the world and spaces in which we find ourselves as we seek to extend the kingdom of God through that peace as well. With that in mind, we share our faith together as we come and share the kingdom prayer, the Lord's prayer, the prayer that Jesus taught us. Now I'm going to be praying in English, and I want to invite you to pray whichever language is easiest on your tongue. Let us pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Friends, as we continue to worship God in this our e-service, we sing together, Our God is an awesome God. Let us worship God together in this moment, friends.
Thank you. selfish thing he is working on the risk. Our God is an awesome God. There is thunder in his footsteps and lightning in his fist. Our God is an awesome God. And the Lord wasn't joking when he kicked him out of Eden. It wasn't for no reason that he shed his blood. His return is very close, so you better be believing that our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. Too quickly forgot that our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom.
Friends, our notices today are found within the video description of this video and have also been made available both through our WhatsApp info groups and on our Facebook pages. And I want to encourage you to take a moment to read through it so that you're aware of what's taking place in our community of faith, particularly as we enter Holy Week and our Easter celebrations as well. So there are a few I'd like to highlight for your attention. The first is our Easter and Holy Week celebrations. Now, we've arrived at Holy Week, beginning today on Palm Sunday with our services that we enter in this moment. And we'll be working our way to the cross of Good Friday and the empty tomb of the risen Christ of Easter Resurrection Sunday. So friends, I want to invite you to journey with us through Holy Week, beginning with our journey today as we go through our Palm Sunday service, either in person or one of our e-services, or if you're joining through our live stream as well, welcome. We'll be making as well from tomorrow, that's Monday, all the way through to Saturday of Holy Week, daily reflections available that will journey us through the week with Jesus as we lead up to the cross of Good Friday through Holy Saturday. And then on Sunday, we will have our Easter Resurrection Sunday sermon. And I want to encourage you to take a few minutes every morning just to spend time listening to our daily reflection or reading through the text that is made available as well. They will be available at 6 a.m. every morning on our WhatsApp info groups. So friends, if you're not part of one of our WhatsApp info groups, please do send me a message and I'll gladly add you to one of our WhatsApp groups. Now with that said, I'm going to put an image on the screen. There we go. This is our Holy Week and Easter program for 2021. And I want to invite you to participate in our services this coming week as well. Now, we'll have three services this week. That will be Maundy Thursday on the 1st of April. We will have an in-person worship service at New Table Methodist Church at 6:30 p.m. That's 6:30 in the evening. We join together at New Table Methodist Church for a combined in-person worship service. There will also be a live stream of the service made available. So join us through either live stream or in person for our Maundy Thursday celebrations. Then on the 2nd of April, we will be having our Good Friday service at 8 a.m. Now we're synchronizing with all of our services within the Mahale circuit. That will be our service at New Table Methodist Church, at Princess Methodist Church, as well as the two vernacular services which will be taking place at Kagiso Methodist Church and Manzival Methodist Church at 8 a.m. on Good Friday. We will also have a live stream of the Noitevel service made available. So I want to encourage you to use the link that is found within our video description and our notices to access that service. It will also be made available through our WhatsApp info groups. We will then have our Sunday Easter resurrection services. Now, please note that our Sunday services will be at their normal times. We'll have our 7:45 in-person worship service at Krugersdorp Methodist Church. We'll have our 8 a.m. sermon e-service, our 8:30 children's e-service, our 9 a.m. worship e-service, as well as our 9:30 Noitevel Methodist Church service, which will be both an in-person worship service as well as a live stream service, as well as our 9:30 Princess Methodist Church in-person worship service. So friends, I want to invite you to join us as we journey through this holy time of the year, as we prepare ourselves for Easter and for the cross of Good Friday, as we journey through the week with Jesus to the cross and the empty tomb of Resurrection Sunday as well. All the details are found within our notices, as well as the links to the live stream services. I'll make the e-service links for Sunday available closer to the time. Second from my side is the problem has been resolved with our church office telephone lines. So you can get me on our 011 numbers. All the details are found within our description of our notices as well. Friends, with that said, I'd like to thank those who continue to give so generously into the life of our communities of faith at this time. Thank you. As you give of your tithes and offerings, we as a church receive it and we use it for the extension of the kingdom of God. To cover the cost of ministry, that's obviously the site costs that we have, as well as of mission as we reach out to the world around us, both within our society, our circuit, our synod, and our connection within the structures of the Methodist Church of Southern Africa. So thank you as you continue to give. If you're joining us today, friends, and you're not from one of our communities of faith, I'd like to encourage you to give into your community of faith. They need your giving as much as we need our members to give at this time. If you'd like to give into our community of faith, you're more than welcome to do so. The banking details are found within our notices, and I'd like to encourage you to make an electronic deposit or join us for one of our in-person worship services and put your tithes and offerings through the offertory in that space, which is normally taken as a retiring offering. With that said, we come to a moment of prayer. Let us lift this all up to God and pray. So, Father, as we plan to celebrate Holy Week, as we continue to journey with you, we ask that you would reach out and touch us, heal us and transform us as we journey with Jesus through this sacred journey, this holy journey. Guide and direct us as only you can, Almighty God, that we may feel and encounter afresh the risen Christ. Help us, we pray. Father, as we give our tithes and our offerings out of love for you, we thank you that you receive it and that you use it for the furtherment of your kingdom. So receive our love gifts for you, Almighty God. Give those who administer it wisdom, guiding, and directing, that they may use it for the extension of your kingdom. For we ask this all in your precious name, Jesus, now and always. Amen. Friends, as we continue to worship God in this time, and prepare our hearts to receive the word of God, we sing together, Crown Him with Many Crowns. Friends, let us worship God. Friends, as we come to the Word of God today, we have one scripture reading. And our scripture reading is from the Gospel of Matthew. I'm going to be reading Matthew 21, verses 1 to 11. And I want to encourage you, if you have a Bible nearby, to open your Bible and to follow with me as we go through our scripture readings. I'm also going to make the words available on the screen. And I'd like to invite you to follow with me as we go through our reading from Matthew 21, verses 1 to 11, from the New International Version of the Holy Bible. And it reads as follows. As they approached Jerusalem and came to Bethpage on the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you, and at once you will find a donkey tied there, with her colt by her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, say that the Lord needs them, and he will send them right away." This took place to fulfill what was spoken through the prophet. "Daughter of Zion, see, your king comes to you gently and riding on a donkey and on a colt, the foal of a donkey." The disciples went and did as Jesus had instructed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and placed their cloaks on them for Jesus to sit on. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, while others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowd that went ahead of him and those that followed shouted, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest!" When Jesus entered Jerusalem, the whole city was stirred and asked, "Who is this?" The crowd answered, "This is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee." Friends, this is our reading, and I pray that God would bless it to our understanding as we search God's scriptures today. Let us pray. Almighty God, as we come to search your scriptures, we ask that you'd open our hearts and our minds to understand and to receive what it is you are saying to us through them. So may the words of my mouth and the meditation of each and every one of our hearts be pleasing to you, our rock and our redeemer, Jesus Christ our Lord, now and always. Amen. Friends, today as we come to the Word of God, we remember Palm Sunday, a day in which Jesus rode triumphantly into Jerusalem as the Messiah, as the King of the Jews, with people waving palm branches and laying them on the road, as well as their coats, in front of Jesus as a sign of respect, as a royal welcome for Jesus as he enters into Jerusalem. Now, by now, the city of Jerusalem was busy filling up with pilgrims coming to the temple for the Passover festival and celebrations. The pilgrims come seeking to worship God and to give thanksgiving offerings and to ask God's continued faithfulness. As they celebrate this, they come to celebrate the deliverance of God and God's people from slavery as well. They were in Jerusalem to remember and to celebrate the Passover event. Friends, it is people from this crowd that were in Jerusalem and on their way into Jerusalem that greet Jesus, the one who has done miraculous signs. We read in the Gospel of John how he raised Lazarus from the grave. Throughout all the Gospels, how Jesus healed many people. He spoke and he taught with authority, bringing a message that the kingdom of God is near and that all people need to repent and believe. This is the Jesus that people had heard about and are now coming to see and even to worship. And as they come singing, "Hosanna." In other words, save, redeem, liberate, set us free. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the King of Israel. Friends, as we journey and begin our Holy Week journey today on Palm Sunday, we begin our journey with Jesus, as well as within ourselves. As we begin to build up to the cross of Good Friday and the discovery of the empty tomb and the risen Christ of Easter Sunday. Now, we've spent the last 5 weeks preparing ourselves. We've journeyed through a very disrupted season of Lent, a time when we have fasted and spent time drawing near to God in prayer and reading our Bibles. Finding ourselves in a very different circumstance under national lockdown in which we find ourselves at this moment. In other words, we stopped from when we came on the 17th of February on Ash Wednesday. And we've journeyed a spiritual journey of preparing ourselves for Easter to encounter the risen Christ afresh. In preparing today and for today's message, the word Hosanna has stuck with me. The word save us has stuck with me. It's been lingering in my mind, and I want to spend some time today examining what this Hosanna that we read about in the Bible is all about. In our reading today, we encounter the following as Jesus prepares himself for the triumphal entry. Jesus sent two of his disciples to go to the town of Bethpage. This is a town just before Jerusalem. As Jesus is preparing to take his final journey to Jerusalem towards the cross, Jesus tells two of his disciples to go to the village ahead. And we find in our reading in verse 2 and 3, "Go to the village ahead of you, and at once you will find a donkey tied there with her colt by her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, say that the Lord needs them, and he will send them right away." Friends, Jesus is preparing the scene. Now, many scholars suggest that this may have actually been a lived parable, a moment in which Jesus is unveiling his true identity as the Messiah, the long-awaited one who God has sent to save, to set free, to liberate, to redeem God's people. Now, the gospel writer of Matthew tells us that all of this was taking place to fulfill what Scripture tells us in Zechariah 9:9. "Say to daughter Zion, see, your king is coming to you gently and riding on a donkey, and on the foal, the colt of a donkey." Friends, this tells us something about who Jesus is. Jesus is the Messiah, the King of the Jews, the one who has come to save God's people, not as a military liberator with a massive war horse commanding a mighty army, as many had expected of the Messiah, to come and overthrow the Roman oppressors and all who opposed Israel. Instead, Jesus comes as a humble and gentle Savior, one riding on a donkey. This was a symbol to all who had eyes to see, that Jesus was coming as a peacemaker, as the Prince of Peace. Our reading goes on, friends, and we read from verse 6 to verse 9. "The disciples went and did as Jesus had instructed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and placed their cloaks on them for Jesus to sit on. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, while others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowd that went ahead of them and those that followed shouted, 'Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.'" Friends, this is a royal procession. A royal procession that begins outside of Jerusalem and goes down into Jerusalem, perhaps through the city gates and into the temple area. A royal procession leading towards Jerusalem is forming. Some go in front of Jesus, who is riding on the donkey in the middle. Those going in front shout and wave palm branches and are laying them on the road, as well as their cloaks. And others that follow are singing and shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven." Friends, I don't know about you, but this is a moment of celebration. A royal procession of celebration as they enter into Jerusalem. Could we call it a moment of worship and praise to Jesus, the one who is the Messiah coming into Jerusalem to set God's people free? Friends, the people are praising. But I also believe in the same moment that they are crying out, "Save us, Son of David. Save us, God's chosen one, born in the line of David, who is from God, sent to set us free." As the procession makes its way into Jerusalem, our reading concludes inside Jerusalem, just outside the temple courts, when we are told in our reading verse 10 and 11. When Jesus entered Jerusalem, the whole city was stirred and asked, "Who is this?" The crowd answered, "This is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee." Do you hear those words, friends? Who is this? I can imagine all the people in wonder in that moment saying, "Who is this that gets such a royal welcome? Who is this that rides triumphantly into Jerusalem? Who is this?" And the crowd that were with him answer, "This is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee." Friends, as we begin our Holy Week journey, we too enter Jerusalem with Jesus, with singing and cries of Hosanna. Perhaps we need to stop and ask ourselves the question, who is this? And what are our expectations of Jesus as we sing our Hosannas? As we sing, save us, Son of David, the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Friends, the disciples who had journeyed with Jesus, who knew Jesus, to whom he had openly told what was going to happen in Jerusalem and what he was about to do, were there. Maybe we, like the disciples of Jesus, who know Jesus, who have spent time learning from Jesus, have seen Jesus for who he truly is, who know Jesus and what he is about to happen, but are not sure about it. Perhaps the disciples had their doubts and their fears. And as we gather today, shout, Hosanna, Hosanna, we come bringing to Jesus our doubts and our fears as well. Perhaps our concerns for ourselves and our families at this time of COVID-19, of lockdown, of economic hardship, of certain unrests that have taken place in our country at this time. Fears of the looming third wave of the coronavirus, COVID-19, and the various variants thereof. It's into that space, friends, that we get to cry out, Hosanna, Jesus, save us. Maybe we, like the crowd on the road, were caught up in the moment and become part of the royal procession into Jerusalem. Perhaps they must have seen Jesus, heard him teach, seen Jesus perform miracles, or been healed or fed by Jesus as well. Friends, they recognize Jesus as the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee, but have not realized the full extent of who Jesus is. Their expectation is of a prophet, not of a Messiah. Perhaps as they cry Hosanna, they have problems and burdens that they are wanting to bring to God through worship at the temple and the Passover celebrations. As they worship and shout Hosanna, God hears them and God is ready and willing to save them. Hosanna, Jesus saves us from our sins and heals us, bringing us into relationship with God. Friends, perhaps maybe we, like the crowd in the city of Jerusalem, those who see the triumphal entry processing into Jerusalem, hear the noise and the shouting, see the sight of this royal entry, and hear the Hosanna cries. Our scripture reading tells us in verse 10, when Jesus entered Jerusalem, the whole city was stirred and asked, who is this? Friends, the crowds that had journeyed with Jesus answered, this is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee. They may have heard about Jesus, but now they get to see him. Perhaps they have no expectations about Jesus, or maybe they're intrigued about who this Jesus is. Some biblical scholars suggest that the question is more along the lines of, what is all this excitement about Jesus? What is it about him that has you so excited? As the crowd shouts Hosanna, many of the people who hear the shouts turn to Jesus and are saved. They shout Hosanna and they're saved. Friends, Hosanna, Jesus, please save those who need your salvation. Lift up these people to God and tell them who Jesus is, the one who saves. So friends, as I close today, I want to say that as we journey through Holy Week, beginning today at thus our Palm Sunday celebrations, may we not lose the essence of the Hosanna of Palm Sunday. The cry of Hosanna, the cry for help, for liberation for our sins, that leads us to the cross of Good Friday and just discovering afresh the empty tomb of Easter Sunday. Hosanna, Hosanna, save us, save us. So friends, I want to invite you to take your palm cross in your hand if you have one with you. We did make opportunity for them to be collected from our church sites this week so that you could have them with you for our service. Perhaps in this moment, if you don't have it, just raise your hands as if you're praising God as well. If you have your palm cross, I want to invite you to hold it. If not, just your hands up as well. And I want to invite you to shout with me, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heavens. Can we say it again? Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Friends, can I encourage you today and this week as we journey through Holy Week to perhaps stop and to take the Hosanna into your quiet time, into the time that you set aside, that you make to be with God, asking God to save you in all areas of your lives and to lift the areas of your life to God where you need salvation, Christ's salvation in those moments. And then in that time of prayer, ask God to help you. With that, we come to a time of prayer. Let us pray. Father, as we come and we hear this Hosanna cries in our reading today, we cry out ourselves, Hosanna, Hosanna, save us, save us. Father, as we come to Palm Sunday, we remember that we begin a journey of love towards the cross. And we ask that you'd help us as we journey with Jesus to embrace the salvation, the saving that comes through the Messiah, the one you have sent to bring us back into relationship with you. So, Father, help us to hear what we need to hear from the sermon today, that we may put it in practice in our lives as we continue to seek to grow in relationship with you, and strengthen us for the journey of this Holy Week as we journey with you, Almighty God. For we ask this all in your precious name, Jesus, now and always. Amen. So friends, as you respond to the word of God this morning, I want to invite you to grab your palm cross if you have one nearby, or just simply lift your hands as we sing together in response to what God has done and continues to do in our lives. As we sing, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Friends, let us worship God as we come in this moment of response. Friends, as we come to an end of our time of service today, I want to remind you to continue to journey with us as we journey through this Holy Week together. A reminder that we have our daily reflections that will be made available from Monday to Saturday. I want to encourage you to find them on our WhatsApp info groups and to journey with us as we journey to the cross, through the cross, and encounter the risen Christ as well. A reminder of our Maundy Thursday services in person, as well as our live stream that will be made available at 6:30 on Thursday. We then have our Good Friday services at 8 a.m., which will also be made available both in person at our Noiteville site, Princess site, Kagiso site, Munzeville site. I want to invite you to join us in person or via our live stream for that service as well. And then we have our Easter Sunday resurrection services. And I want to encourage you to join us for those services. They will be in our normal time slots, 7:45 at Krugersdorp Methodist Church. We then have our e-services, our 8 a.m. sermon e-service, our 8:30 children's e-service, our 9 a.m. worship e-service. We also have our 9:30 worship service at Noiteville Methodist Church, as well as at Princess Methodist Church, and our live stream service at 9:30 from Noiteville as well. So friends, I want to invite you to join us as we journey together through this Holy Week as brothers and sisters in Christ, seeking Christ to understand who this Jesus is. As we come to close our time, we bless each other with what's known as the benediction. The words are now on the screen. I'm going to invite you to say them with me as we bless each other as we depart. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and evermore. Amen. Friends, be blessed, stay safe, and know that God is with you, now and always. Amen.